With this first analysis, we're going to look at how gender roles are being played with in Psycho. With this first image, we can see how Marion is lying prone while Sam is standing above her in what looks like a position of authority, particularly in a sexual sense, given the setting and the placement of Sam's pelvis in relationship to Marion's head, which is quite suggestive of fellatio. In this next scene, we can see how the roles have been reversed, and now Marion is the one in control. Visually, we can see how Marion is now standing above Sam, but that's not all. Sam wants to extend the day, he wants to stay with her and cuddle. He even offers to come down next weekend, and she says no. And she's the one getting dressed and trying to get out of there. This is also a reversal of a common stereotype of the man after a one-night stand who can't get dressed fast enough and get out of there, while the woman wishes he would stay. While Marion is at once breaking stereotypes, she also falls into the stereotype of the woman who is trying to pressure her boyfriend into marrying her. After all, she is the Marion type. In this scene, we see and hear Sam give up when he says, "All right." Marion is again above Sam, looking down on him, the one visually in power here, with Sam opening his arms and acquiescing. This image is a lot like Christ coming down from the cross. John Gavin, the actor who is playing Sam, very carefully drops the towel over his crotch, creating what looks like a loincloth. I think this is very deliberate because it reflects so many of the images of Christ descending the cross. Here are a couple of images to show you what I'm talking about. It's almost like the image is saying that Marion asking for this marriage is crucifying Sam. Sam has essentially been emasculated, not so much by Marion, but by the culture that tells him he's not man enough to be married. He's just about to list off a whole bunch of different reasons why he can't afford to be married. So it establishes all of these kind of roles that men have to struggle with in our culture. Let's take a look at the scene.
All right. Marry him whenever is possible. I want to see you. And under any circumstances, even respectability.
You make respectability sound disrespectful.
Oh, no, I'm all for it. It requires patience, temperance, a lot of sweating out. Otherwise, though, it's just hard work. But if I could see you and touch you even as simply as this, I won't mind. I'm tired of sweating for people who aren't there. I sweat to pay off my father's debts and he's in his grave. I sweat to pay my ex-wife alimony and she's living on the other side of the world somewhere.
I pay too. They also pay who meet in hotel rooms.
After Sam rifles off his list of items that are holding him back, Marion sits down, shifting again visually the power structure, so now she's lower than Sam, and says, "I pay too. They also pay who meet in hotel rooms." So the question becomes, who waits in the hotel rooms? And clearly it's women like Marion who have to sit on the sidelines while the men have to establish themselves in their roles as men. So we get a sense of why Marion decides to steal the money, to essentially take that role that Sam is so worried about. But what Marion doesn't seem to recognize is that Sam wouldn't take that money because he needs to be the breadwinner. And this sets off a string of encounters that Marion has with men who have authority over her, until she finally meets Norman, someone else who is struggling to deal with the definition of what it means to fit into his gender.